Hey guys, in this video we're going to be continuing on with our PreSonus Studio One tutorial series. Last time we looked at getting the software installed on our computer and how to get everything set up and running so we can start recording. In this video we'll go over some of the basics of recording an audio track and making edits to that track. Let's start by creating our first audio track. We're starting with the blank new project from our first video. On the left side of the screen, right-click and select Add Audio Track. If you'll be recording one microphone, you should set it to mono. If you have two microphones together for a stereo pair on an instrument, set it as stereo to work with them together. Now we need to set our input with a dropdown on this track. This is where we'll run into one of the first limitations of the Prime version of Studio One, since we can only use two inputs from our audio interface instead of the 16 that mine is normally able to record at once. With the full version, you can access all these inputs at the same time. If you only have an audio interface with one or two inputs, this isn't an issue for you at all. But for those with more complicated audio interfaces, you might want to consider using the full version or choosing another free digital audio workstation. Check out our video on the channel to learn more about a few of those. You may notice that we can only see two inputs right now. We need to select Audio I/O Setup and link our audio interface inputs to the input on the Studio One by pairing them up on this grid. Once these inputs are set up, press the Apply button. You may also want to save them as default so they're set up each time you go to record from now on. Now exit this menu. To be able to record, press the white circle on the track. This will arm the track for recording, and you'll notice that the button turns red, telling us it's armed. The track will stay armed until we press this button again. When a track is armed for recording, that track will record when we press the record button on the project. Only armed tracks will record, and unarmed tracks will just play back normally without recording. You'll notice that as you press the arm button, you can hear the sound from that track in your headphones, and that's a great way to tell it's working and what it will sound like when we record it. If you want to disable that so you don't hear it, press the button to the right that's lit up in blue. The M button to the left is to mute the track. Muted tracks won't play when we play the project. The S button is to solo the track. Soloing means that only soloed tracks will play, and tracks that do not have the solo button pressed will not play. These two buttons allow you to quickly turn tracks on and off in the project and listen to them on their own without having to adjust the volume level on the track. You'll also see the level indicator in green that shows how loud the track is recording. If the little red box shows at the top, that means the track is clipping. You need to reduce the level and redo that recording, since clipping means it's recorded at too high of a level. Try and set the level properly before recording to avoid this. With the track armed, we can press the white circle in the bottom center of the screen to start recording on our track. You'll see as we do this that a new clip is being created with that track, and there's little squiggles that represent the sound wave telling us how loud it is. If we want to restart and delete that track, we can use the undo shortcut on the keyboard, or we can right-click and select delete. You can also click the clip and press the delete key on the keyboard. We'll see now that there's a little line in the middle of the screen. This represents where in time we are on the project, and it was initially at the beginning. To get it back to the beginning, we can press the line with the left arrow at the bottom. This is the button to the left of the stop button. We can also click on the timeline to snap it to that point in time. With the clip recorded, we can make a few edits. One of the things you might want to do is trim the clip. This can be used to remove the noise at the beginning and end of the clip without changing the position in the song. You want to be careful not to change the position if you've recorded it with other tracks, since it won't line up if you do that. To trim a clip, hover over the edge of the clip and then click and drag towards the center of the clip. Similarly, if you click and drag at the top edge of the clip, you'll get a fade at the beginning or end to get a smooth fade in or out. Clicking and dragging towards the center of the clip will allow you to move it in time along the timeline. Be careful if you do this, as it can put the track out of sync. To adjust the volume of the track, click and drag on the bar just below the track buttons we looked at earlier. Dragging to the left makes the track quieter, and dragging to the right makes it louder. Be careful if you turn it up too much. This can cause the track to clip, which will lead to some distortion. To adjust the volume of an individual clip, drag the center square up or down. Thanks for checking out this video on recording audio with PreSonus Studio One. For more videos on this topic and others like it, don't forget to give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for products featured in this video and social media links.